Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about cells. These cells are more commonly known as batteries. So what is battery? Any battery that we can use is a simple arrangement of electrochemical cells that can be used as a source of direct electric current at a constant voltage. Here, these electrochemical cells convert the chemical energy of the redox reaction into electrical energy. So, battery is a device which provides direct electric current as a constant voltage. There are mainly two types of commercial batteries. Number one is primary battery, or we can also say as primary cells, and second one is secondary batteries, or we can also say as secondary cells. First, we are going to discuss about primary cells. So, what is primary cells? In primary cells, the electrode reactions cannot be reversed by any external energy source. So, in this type of cells, reactions occurs only once, and after use, battery becomes dead. That means primary cells are not chargeable, so it cannot be reused. Examples of primary cell includes dry cells, battery cells, etc. First, we are going to discuss about dry cells. Dry cells are used in a torch, toys, tape recorders, etc. This is the figure of simple dry cell. Dry cell consists of zinc cylinder, which is filled with moist paste of ammonium chloride and zinc chloride. So, this zinc cylinder is act as anode, that means negative electrode. This carbon rod is act as cathode. It is surrounded by a black powder of manganese oxide and carbon. These dry cells have an iron or steel sheet covering the zinc cylinder. This is the positive terminal of the battery, and there is the negative terminal of the battery. When the cell is working, zinc loses electrons and zinc ions dissolve in the electrolyte, and these electrons are taken up at cathode, which causes discharge of ammonium ions from the electrolyte. So, this is the reaction which occurs at anode, where zinc loses electron and forms zinc ion, and this ion is taken by the cathode and produce ammonium ion. So, at a cathode, manganese is reduced and ammonia is formed at the cathode, but it is not liberated as a gas. It combines with zinc ion and forming a complex having a formula ZnNH3CL2. So students, this is all about dry cell. Next example of primary cell is mercury cell. Mercury cell is used in small electrical circuits like in watches. Mercury cell consists of a zinc anode and a mercury oxide cathode. A paste of KOH and ZnO is filled between two electrodes. So the reaction occurs in the cells are as follows. This is the anode reaction and this is the cathode reaction. Mercury cell gives constant potential of 1.35 volt used in hearing aids, watches, etc. So students, this is all about primary cells. Secondary cells we will discuss in next video. Thank you.